Global oil prices rose to seven-year highs Wednesday as worries persist about supply disruptions and an already tight outlook. Brent crude climbed to $88 per barrel, while U.S. West Texas Intermediate crude settled at nearly $87 per barrel. Security concerns pushed prices to their highest since October 2014, following drone and missile strikes on the United Arab Emirates by Yemen's Houthi group, which set off explosions in fuel trucks. The Houthi group warned it could target more facilities, adding to worries for global oil traders, rising tensions between major producer Russia and Ukraine.
Measure not keen on revising growth targets yet for this year. This even as Metro Manila and several other areas revert to COVID-19 alert level 3. Officials earlier said the economy could bleed some 3 billion pesos for every week that the stricter alert level is retained. But the National Economic and Development Authority under Secretary Rosemary Edilion says it's still too early to revise the targets. Economic managers expect the Philippine economy to grow by 7% to 9% this year.
The Philippine Transportation Department awards to a Chinese contractor the $2.8 billion PNR South long-haul railway project. The 380-kilometer railway will link Calamba Laguna to Legazpi Albay and cut travel time from 12 to 4 hours. The contractor is a joint venture between China Railway Group and China Railway Engineering Consulting Group. Chinese Ambassador to the Philippines Wang Zilian calls the deal another milestone for China-Philippines cooperation and the highest-funded government-to-government project between the two countries.
A group of billionaires and millionaires issues an unusual plea at the World Economic Forum. As this report tells us, they want world leaders to make them pay more taxes.
Make us pay more tax. That was the message a group of billionaires and millionaires had for leaders convening virtually for the World Economic Forum. The group calls itself the Patriotic Millionaires and is made up of more than 100 ultra-wealthy individuals, including Disney heiress Abigail Disney. They say they should be forced to help pay for the pandemic response and tackle the gulf between rich and poor. In an open letter published on Wednesday, the group said, quote, "While the world has gone through an immense amount of suffering in the last 2 years, we have actually seen our wealth rise. Yet few, if any of us, can honestly say that we pay our fair share in taxes." That sentiment was echoed by Oxfam, which on Monday published a report detailing how the super rich have thrived during the health crisis. The charity details how the world's 10 wealthiest people more than doubled their fortunes to $1.5 trillion during the pandemic. Oxfam President and CEO, Abby Maxman.
We've really had, during the pandemic, an inequality explosion. And it's been a period that has been an unprecedented boom for billionaires. 99% of humanity is being left behind. So as we've watched billionaire growth double at the rate of $15,000 per second, that's the same $80 less per second than a minimum wage worker makes in a year.
The Patriotic Millionaires Group is calling for an annual wealth tax on those with fortunes of more than $5 million. They say that could raise more than $2.5 trillion and pull more than 2 billion people out of poverty. Last year, the World Bank urged countries to consider a wealth tax to help reduce inequality, replenish state coffers depleted by COVID-19 relief programs, and regain social trust. However, outside Argentina and Colombia, no new wealth tax schemes have been initiated since the start of the pandemic.
New York State Attorney General Letitia James takes legal action to compel former U.S. President Donald Trump and his children Ivanka and Donald Jr. to testify in her civil investigation into the Trump Organization's financial dealings. James says they have evidence showing the Trump Organization used fraudulent and misleading asset valuations and multiple properties to obtain economic benefits, including loans and tax deductions. The Attorney General has been investigating the Trump Organization since 2019. The camp of the former president has yet to comment on the matter.